with Action Express, and I'm the spotter for the 31 car. This is probably the least taxing job out here physically. Mentally, it's a completely different story.
You got the track to yourself.
What we're going through is something really special.
Cadillac knows prototype endurance racing. With four consecutive overall wins at the Rolex 24 at Daytona and three IMSA WeatherTech Sports Car Championships, Cadillac has more than a few trophies in its case. But this year is different. An all-new prototype class, IMSA GTP, is amping up the challenge for the Cadillac racing team.
The GTP class is a purpose-built race car. It's not a production-based car.
The world stage, we're going to run a Cadillac.
Winning Daytona this year will take mastering a new kind of car, one that combines proven Cadillac V8 power with electric propulsion.
The 24 hours of Daytona is grueling.
It's a very iconic race. It's massive in terms of what it means for the industry as a whole and what it means for automotive manufacturers.
Having a proof point of your technology from a craftsmanship and performance standpoint, that's why we race.
Cadillac's third generation prototype racing car will race globally with a look that's unmistakably Cadillac. Goal is to endure 24 hours of racing to win at Daytona and then to go on and do the same thing at the Le Mans 24 hour.
If you are a nut about sports car racing like I am, the dream is to go win at Le Mans.
It's an ambitious plan that will see Cadillac competing on the world motorsports stage for the first time in two decades. For Cadillac Racing, it will be a very busy 2023.
This is where all the top class drivers are going to meet. Daytona 2023.
Essentially, the FIA gives you a performance window that you have to stay in. If you want to do a four-cylinder with a big turbo, you can do that. If you want to do a naturally aspirated V8, you can do that.
So with the new hybrid system and mass being a huge concern, aren't we kind of shooting ourselves in the foot by choosing to go with this V8?
I don't think we are. Powertrain foundations are preferential, but we know naturally aspirated V8s. Mm-hmm. If we can hit all of the attributes that are required for the program, why not go with what we're really good at?
Number cold tires.
The engine, in my mind, because I'm engine-centric, it's the heartbeat of the car. It's kind of the signature, and I think that that's unique for us. There's not a lot of people that can say when they have an engine building group that really knows their parts. I think our guys are probably the most knowledgeable of any engine building group I've ever worked with. Jim Ingerson's been an engine builder probably as long as anybody that I've known.
I don't know, Ian, can I tell him what it is? We're calling it an LMC55R. It's 5.5 liter, 4-valve, 4-cam. It's cross-plane crankshaft. It's a 90-degree crankshaft. It really sounds good at the racetrack. This is the first of the first for this engine, this hybrid, this car. It's pretty important we get it right.
The more we can get done in preparation, the better.
Here in Atlanta, less than 3 months before the Rolex 24, every lap is critical. Drivers and technical teams get acquainted with the new Cadillac VLMDA.
Trying to get a feel for the where we're at. Everybody good? Jeff, are you in the back? Okay, Ryan?
Yeah, we can go.
Okay. I was going to let him do one more time lap. He's working it now. Let's go ahead and pit this lap. Pit this lap out.
Keep everybody happy is probably the hardest thing. Everybody's trying to be a perfectionist, myself included.
Quite a bit of setup changes and setup work. We're just trying to get the car in the right window and make it go faster.
All right,
think we need to keep developing the car as planned. We have the power where we want it, so let's try to make sure everything gets addressed before we go out, and then we'll try to make it out when we can in the morning, but make sure everything what we wanted to get fixed is fixed.
It's really cool that we've got the two organizations helping us run the team, because I think they're so different in who they historically are. You've got Chip Ganassi, right, coming from IndyCar side of things, where they're using a spec chassis now, and everything is same across the team, so it's all about how refined can your engineering get, right? How much can you push this car to the nth degree? And then on the other side of things, you've got Action Express, who has a very storied history in sports car racing, which is how do we leverage our platform, which is different than everybody else, and the quirks and the unique features, and turn that into a winning machine.
I'm a technology guy, but I'm old school. I've been making a living at racing for more than 5 decades. So I always embrace the new things that are coming, because I think we have to keep advancing the sport.
Why choose Cadillac? Why do this?
Because of the heritage of Cadillac and General Motors. To be a part of a program like this is a real feather in our cap. All car companies have had their eyes opened up with new technology coming on board and how fast cars are going from idea or concept to production.
We're going to run a Cadillac to win the hardest race there is to win, the 24 hours of Daytona, and beat all of those full effort factories. I am so motivated to do that.
One of these cars has a soul. So it's important to have something that stands out from the crowd, speaks to the brand. We also really want to celebrate the three colors.
So cars have been wrapped. These are the final images that are going to go out for the livery reveal.
Oh,
so,
first time the group's seen them?
This is the first time you guys have
seen them.
I was
going to
say, please enjoy the hotness every
week. That's amazing.
Don't want something to be a walk in the park. You want something that is competitive. You want to be out there. You want to be racing with the best, and you want to be able to put your best foot forward, and ultimately you want to win.
To an outsider, it looks like we stand up and watch the race. To an insider, we can see and hear things that they otherwise don't know.
There's not a better job in the world if you love cars.
Launching a new Cadillac prototype racing car. It all comes down to one long race, the Rolex 24.